yeah, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drill. Little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill. Little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big.
We're about 40 miles south of Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the San Francisco 49ers.
For San Francisco.
Two teams fighting for one berth in Super Bowl 55 in Tampa. Let's do it. It's NFC Championship time. This will make it into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. First carry for LeSean McCoy. LeSean McCoy off to the races.
It's over.
Touchdown, it's over. Tampa Bay.
LeSean McCoy.
77 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. On this stage, conference championship game, every play is magnified, and that was a big play.
No doubt about it. One thing that has these guys a step away from a shot at the big game, their big play ability. They can strike from anywhere.
Fielded in the end zone.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Raheem Mostert. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
The ball carrier.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Garoppolo going to give to Mostert. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down.
It's a gain of 2. Brings up 3rd and 3.
The Bucs with an extra defender now in the secondary here on 3rd down. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a pickup of 6. First down, San Francisco.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner. But to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big 3rd down pickup to keep their drive alive.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Play action, Garoppolo. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
But they certainly came out firing in this one. And while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. That's complete to John Ross. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Devin White on the tackle. A gain of 9. Brings up second and 1.
On second down, Mostert. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs 31.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First and 10, it's Mostert. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Here's Garoppolo tossing quickly out wide. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
9-yard line.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Here's Mostert. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on 2nd and goal. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation.
Well, it looked like a quick hitter, a 3-step drop. But when it's not there, what do? He elects to try and escape through the massive bodies up the middle, and he does so and picks up positive yardage.
They'll run with Mostert. And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown. Are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
The kick is good.
And he's got it up and through.
Ties the game at 7. Robbie Gould to kick off for
each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Their own 18-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
They'll keep it on the ground with McCoy this time. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36.
Jason Barrett.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Second and four at the 36.
Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. These two teams all tied after one. Now Jones. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Hey, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. On second down, it's McCoy. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
Taken down at the 50.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Down.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46.
He was tackled.
I like the look that they just showed there. When you come out in a passing formation, spread things out a little bit, makes it really hard to cover the middle of the field, doesn't it? Because you got to go out to the perimeter and cover those guys.
Yep, exactly. Got some good blocking, too. Helped him pick up the first. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. First down, Tampa Bay there, a gain of 13.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
He's brought down.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Now he'll throw with Brady. He finds his target. It's Evans. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. 16 yards, a first down.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. He will push his way down to about the 14. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. Two-yard gain.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
To number 13.
A 14-yard touchdown. And the Bucs have taken the lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
24-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. 2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. And a reminder, folks, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report coming up shortly. The coach with us, as always, as he will start to look ahead to Super Bowl 53. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. A pickup of 5 yards. First down, San Francisco.
36-yard line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. A play fake from Mostert. Now Garoppolo. Deep ball for Goodwin. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And across the chalk into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Marquise Goodwin, 64 yards. And the Niners, if they can convert the extra point, they'll grab the lead. The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag.
Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The drive with a carry by Jones. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
He was brought down by Emmanuel.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
They hand it off to Mostert. First down and a little extra for Mostert. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. They'll get 17 on that one, and the Niners have a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. On first down, they go with Mostert again. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7. At the 12-yard line.
Slam. Check 31. Check 31. Jim. Tighten up.
On the handoff, this is Mostert. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They'll try it now with Mostert, and he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. They'll try and run for it on first and goal, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Second down and goal. Garoppolo. Ooh. weaving through traffic, and now he's free. 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Charles, I'm looking at you, and understandably, your mouth is wide open in disbelief. What were they thinking?
That's going to be one of the great mysteries, but I do know this. When they went out on offense, I will guarantee they told them, don't just make anticipatory throws. Make sure you see it before you throw it. Didn't happen here.
Trying to protect that lead, and now they gave it up. So now with a late touchdown, not only will they take the lead to the locker room, but they'll try and add two more here. Here's Chubb to try to run it in. And he's going to go down in the field of play. So they say no to the field goal try. And time has run out on this first half. All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway of the NFC Championship game. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Sean Murphy Bunting. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Taking it in from 24 yards out. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And this will not be fielded. It's a touchback and comes out to the 25. 5 yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up. So, oh, they intercept Garoppolo for the third time. It's Devin White, the linebacker, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
So after the INT, it's Brady looking for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of four.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. A throw on the quick slant, going to be complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. his first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
36-yard line.
They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. Deep ball for Goodwin. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up the throw. And this is caught by Evans. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory.
Complete.
A big play there on the catch and run. 68 yards. Now Jones. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. One back in the game, that's Jones, second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. And this time they were waiting for him, as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
They'll give it to Chubb, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Well, Charles, fans around here, they were already talking Super Bowl. They've made plans. You just can't look past anybody in this league, especially this deep into the playoffs.
You would think that every year that message would sink in. And it feels like every year we see something like this, especially the way they're handling them. All right? You didn't expect this part to happen. But when you're playing this deep in the playoffs, every team's dangerous.
Oh, I think the Bucs got it, and they did. Tampa Bay football. Well, there you go. Just your everyday leading big and you onside kick it with a lead. They got it. I mean, it worked, but interesting call.
I think because they have such a margin, they feel a little bit bolder about what they're doing. And it's not only just to try and increase their lead, but that's their way of saying we're in full control of this game and we can kind of do what we want.
10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Brady's throw there complete. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 19. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Again, this is Chubb. And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On second down, it's Jones. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Ronald Jones, his second touchdown of the night. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will bump the lead up to 26. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Taken in the end zone.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about. And now here is another interception. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And it's a big turnover there on the final play of the quarter. One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Handoff comes to Chubb. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Ronald Jones, the ball carrier. He was tackled at the 46-yard line. It's a gain of a yard. And this is third down.
The Bucs on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and 9. Now Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their 38. And from the shotgun, he'll throw. Going deep downfield for Ross. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now left side on the swing pass. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Taking a shot for Samuel. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
It's a gain of 8.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a...
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. George Kittle. 30 yards, and the 49ers get a score closer.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on, into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And he stopped immediately there. The Pro Bowl corner, Jason Verrett, on the tackle. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tartt. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Willie Henry in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing on second and long. Garoppolo. Got a man open. It's Ross. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line.
Complete to John Ross. 16 yards on the play. It's now
on play action. Now Garoppolo sliding out of the pocket. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead, and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it?
Yeah, the ball is knocked out, and now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception. Derwin James with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And you can bet that they are starting to sense it now. That George Halas Trophy nearly theirs. Their spot as NFC champions oh so close as they try to finish this one off. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. The end result, 21 yards. A run for Nick Chubb. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. And a tackle there by Quan Alexander.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Now we're at the 41, second and nine. The shotgun, it's McCoy. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
He's brought down at the 42-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and this is third down. Tonight's
final, really a great season, not a whole lot.